Good morning. Welcome to Memorial. I'm glad you are able to join us this morning via live stream and worship here together. My hope is that you would find this day, this worship, a blessing and a time of peace in an otherwise hectic and stressful week. Today is a very special day. Today is a day that we set aside to celebrate our moms. And so I pray that you take a moment this day to remember your mother and celebrate all that she is and does and has done. This morning we are also celebrating in this fifth Sunday after Easter with a reminder that our hope is in the Lord and how great it is that we receive these constant reminders of the Lord's goodness in our life. And sometimes these reminders are huge blessings. Sometimes they are very small, seemingly insignificant gifts, but they serve to keep us mindful that our hope always rests in the Lord. And so this morning as we begin this morning by singing His praises.
You're alive. You rule, you reign. You said you're coming back again. And I know that you will, and all the earth will sing your praises. All the earth will sing your praises. You take a wind away, O God. You gave your life away for us. You came down, you saved us through the cross. Our hearts are changed because of your great love. You live. You died, you said in 3 days you would rise, you did, and you're alive. You rule, you reign, you said you're coming back again. I know that you will, and all the earth will sing your praises. Sins away, oh God. You gave your life away for us. You came down, you saved us through the cross. Our hearts are changed because of your great love. You lived, you died, you said it. Would rise, you did, and you're alive. You rule, you reign, you said you're coming back again. And I know that you will, and all the earth will sing your praises. All the earth will sing your praises.
So we begin this morning by calling on our God, and we do so in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Taste and see that the Lord is good. Blessed are all who take refuge in him.
You and my soul sings out as your word goes down far away. I sing to you and my heart cries, holy hallelujah, Father, you're near. My hope is in you, Lord, all the day long.
Let's pray. Almighty God, by the power of your word, give us a steadfast faith in Jesus Christ, a cheerful hope in your mercy, and a sincere love for you and for one another. Give us a continual taste of the hope that comes from your goodness to us. Through our Savior, Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. Now God speaks his word to us through Scripture.
The epistle reading is taken from 1 Peter chapter 2, verses 2 through 10. In Jesus Christ, God has moved his people from hopelessness to be people who are messengers of his hope. Like newborn babies, crave pure spiritual milk, so that by it you may grow in your salvation. Now that you have tasted that the Lord is good, so as you come to him, the living stone, rejected by men, but chosen by God and precious to him, you also, like living stones, are being built into a spiritual house to be a holy priesthood, offering spiritual sacrifices acceptable to God through Jesus Christ. For in Scripture it says, "See, I lay a stone in Zion, a chosen and precious cornerstone, and the one who trusts in him will never be put to shame. Now to you who believe, this stone is precious. But to those who do not believe, the stone the builders rejected has become the capstone, and the stone that causes men to stumble, and a rock that makes them fall. They stumble because they disobey the message, which is also what they were destined for. You are a chosen people, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a people belonging to God, that you may desire the praises of him who called you into darkness, who called you out of darkness into his wonderful light. Once you were not a people, but now you are the people of God. Once you had not received mercy, but now you have received mercy." This is the word of the Lord. The gospel reading is taken from John chapter 14, verses 1 through 6. "Do not be troubled. Our hope rests in Jesus, who is the only way to the Father." Jesus said, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Trust in God. Trust also in me. In my Father's house there are many rooms. If it were not so, I would have told you. I am going there to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back and take you to be with me, that you also may be where I am. You know the way to the place where I am going." Thomas said to him, "Lord, we do not know where you are going, so how can we know the way?" Jesus said, "I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." This is the word of the Lord.
Well, good morning. It's kids' time and it is Mother's Day. Yay! Hope you are doing something special for your mom today. I need to call my mom yet, but I will call my mom. But I want you to do something special for you. I want to take a pause, and I want all the kids, I want you to go hug your moms right now. And maybe husbands, hug your wives or the grandmas or whoever. Just everybody just stop. Go give hugs. And my dad, go give my mom a hug because I think you're watching. And everybody just go do that. Go give hugs. Ready, set, go. How is it, Mom? Are they giving you hugs? Oh, how cool is that? I dug up, this is a card that has been hanging in my office. This is from my kids from last year. It says, "Mom, you deserve a whole flock of hugs." And so it has all these little Woodstocks all over. And I just loved it. So I hung it up in my office because it's so cute. And it reminds me that my kids love me. 1 Corinthians 16:14 says, "Do everything in love." And today is a special day that we set aside to love our moms, to thank them for all that they do for us, most importantly, the love that they show us. And so there's ways that you can make this a special day for them. You can do the dishes for them. You can wash the black van, hint, hint, hint. You can obey them when they give a direction or something and say, no, I don't want to do that. Just do it. I don't know. Get along with your siblings, but do something very special for your mom today. Help her realize how special she is. God sees us this special every day. He looks at each one of us and says, I love you. And God did everything in love for us. He sent his son Jesus to love us, to save us. And so today, as we celebrate our moms, here's another way to do it. It's just love them. And you can do that every day too. But today's a special day. So let's fold our hands and let's say a prayer. Dear God, thank you so much for giving us our moms, for the love they show us, and how they take care of us, and how they love us. Help us show them how much we love them. Thank you for Jesus, who loves us very much. Amen. So do something special. Maybe draw a picture. Maybe draw a picture for your mom's mom and your dad's dad, which is your grandparents, and tell them, thanks, I love you. Have a great day. Bye.
Well, God's grace to you and his peace through our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, the one who died for us, the one who calls us his very own children. On this Mother's Day, I love the scripture reading out of 1 Peter as a sign for this day, and it starts out like newborn babies. Kind of takes me back to my newborn baby days, you know. Well, okay, I don't really remember that. Some people say they do. But like newborn babies crave pure spiritual milk so that by it you may grow up in your salvation now that you have tasted that the Lord is good. You know, I think of tasting, and you know, when my kids were growing up, when they were just babies, and this is probably before they remember, first time we gave them a dill pickle. You ever do that with a baby? Give them a dill pickle, put it in their mouth, and their face all contorts and goes sour and everything like that. But what my kids did, their faces went sour, and it went out, and then all of a sudden, they grabbed for it again. They wanted it again. Strange, strange taste. But something about that taste they must have liked or wanted again. I got something else to taste here, and I'm just going to show it to you here. It's underneath here. It's my peanut butter sandwich I had prepared just a little bit ago, and you know what? I want to taste just a little bit of it if it doesn't slide off the podium on me here. Just put a little bit of honey on it. Got the nice Honey Bear honey. Thank you, Adam, for bringing this with you home. This Honey Bear honey, put a little bit on there, and all right, it should be nice and sweet. There we go. And oh, probably shouldn't have used peanut butter, but I'm sorry, you're just going to have to wait. Oh, what a taste. Okay, I'll save the rest for later. But that tastes good, and I know something wonderful is still coming up for me there. I had a taste of it. Tasted that the Lord is good. When Peter wrote that, he was quoting from a psalm, Psalm 34, verse 8. Let me read it to you here, very, very brief. It says, taste and see that the Lord is good. Blessed are all who take refuge in him. And the psalm is written at a place where David writes of all the things that are going on. I sought the Lord and he answered me. He delivered me from my fears. He has tough stuff going on in his life, but the Lord was there. And so he says, taste and see that the Lord is good. Blessed are all who take refuge in him. In our reading from the book of Acts, a man named Stephen had quite a taste. Now, Stephen was an apostle, one who was set apart to carry the word of the Lord. In fact, he came into the picture in the early church when the church was dealing with matters like making sure that widows were taken care of, for example, and they set aside people to help make sure that those kinds of things happened. And Stephen was one of those who was involved in that kind of work. And Stephen also began to be known as one who proclaimed the word of the Lord very, very strongly in a very convincing way for folks. In fact, so convincing that there were people who were cut quick to the heart by his words and didn't want to hear any more, because his words carried that law of the Lord which would point out sin, and they weren't so happy to hear things that they had done wrong or that they were doing wrong, or maybe they didn't want to have change in their lives, maybe they had become comfortable with. And so when Stephen began to talk about the word of the Lord, and then he spoke of Jesus Christ, and many of the folks who said, well, what does Jesus have to do with anything? Many who didn't know Jesus and who hadn't grown to understand what it was that Jesus had done for them. Stephen wanted to tell them about it, but before he even got to the part of telling about Jesus carrying the weight of their sins on him, they had gotten so angry and so upset, they started closing their eyes, closing their ears to him. It says they even gnashed their teeth at him. That was a way to show disgust. And they took Stephen out to stone him. You can read about that all in Acts chapter 7. But what I want to read to you is a portion of Acts chapter 7 that starts at verse 51. He continues his message. He says, "You stiff-necked people, was there ever a prophet your fathers did not persecute?" And he says, "You always resist the Holy Spirit." He says, "Was there ever a prophet your fathers did not persecute? They even killed those who predicted the coming of the righteous one. And now you have betrayed and murdered him." And he was speaking the truth. And it was pretty stark, but it was the truth. And this is where people stopped listening to Stephen. And it goes on. They were furious. They gnashed their teeth at him. But Stephen, full of the Holy Spirit, looked up to heaven and saw the glory of God. Here's where this reading connects, I believe, to that reading that says, "Taste and see the Lord is good." Stephen, full of the Holy Spirit, looked up to heaven and saw the glory of God, and Jesus standing at the right hand of God. A taste of God's glory. Even as the people around him were getting angry and mad, "Look," he said, "I see heaven open and the Son of Man standing at the right hand of God." And that's where the people covered their ears and they yelled at the top of their voices. They all rushed at Stephen. They dragged him out of the city and began to stone him. Meanwhile, says Acts, the witnesses laid their clothes at the feet of a young man named Saul, who would later be named Paul, who would be the great missionary who took the word of God to the world. But for now, he was with those who had their ears closed. While they were stoning him, Stephen prayed, "Lord Jesus, receive my spirit." Sound like somebody else, you know, Jesus on the cross? "Father, into your hands I commit my spirit." Stephen, looking to heaven, had a taste of God's glory. Into his mind come these memories, these tastes, which certainly he had heard told to him when Jesus was on the cross. How Jesus, even at the end, said, "Father, into your hands I commit my spirit." And Stephen, because he had tasted that the Lord is good, these words become real for him as well. And he goes on. "Then he fell on his knees and cried out, 'Lord, do not hold this sin against them.' And when he had said this, he fell asleep," which means he died. The next verse says, and Saul was there giving approval to his death. But there's that taste again coming into the picture. Jesus on the cross, looking down at those who are ridiculing him and yelling at him and saying, Father, forgive them. They don't know what they're doing. A taste of the great, forgiving, compassionate love of God. A taste that Stephen certainly had heard about. A taste that came to him as he looked at those around him throwing stones and at his eyes perhaps grew dim. And he cries out, Lord, don't hold this sin against them. And he dies. I expect Stephen really needed those tastes to go through what he went through. You know, tastes in life and the things we experience in life don't always taste good. Some things are very, very tough, very difficult. Sometimes it seems like nothing's going right. Nothing's going the way you want it to. You plan a party and it falls all apart. You plan a job and all of a sudden everything shuts down and you don't have a job. Moms, every day perfect as a mom? Of course not. Each of us grew up with a mom, and that's what this Mother's Day is about, honoring our moms. Is it always perfect with my mom? No. Thank you, God, for the taste of your goodness. Thanks, Mom, for the taste of your goodness to me, too, to bring memories even in tough days when things aren't perfect. You and I live life with good things, bad things, in-between things, everyday things, special things, joyful things, very sorrowful things, grieving things. But we live with hope because we know the taste of the Lord. Now, not that I've seen heaven open like Stephen did, but Stephen's taste took him back to the word of the Lord that was spoken out of the lips of Jesus. Our experiences in life take us back to the word of the Lord, where we've experienced from the lips of Jesus his words that speak comfort, his words to the disciples. Oh, and I just this past week, I was at a funeral. I conducted a funeral in Iowa. And the reading we used was from John chapter 14, where Jesus talks about going and preparing a place, a taste of promise for the disciples. And Jesus said, you know the way to the place where I'm going. And Thomas says, well, Lord, we don't know the way. He hadn't always had that sure experience that he knew exactly what Jesus was doing. And then Jesus gives another taste. Well, Thomas, I am the way and the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. But we have access to the Father in our Savior, Jesus. That's why he came. So that as we live our lives in this world where there are difficulties, where there are problems, and again, these weeks, no exception. For sure? Yeah. But we taste the promises of the word of the Lord. We taste the goodness of God. We've experienced those blessings, sometimes more than other times. Sometimes it feels like they've been far away. But remember the promises of God to you and to me. And taste and see that the Lord is good, and so blessed are we as we take our refuge in Him. So like newborn babies, crave pure spiritual milk, that Word of God that feeds us, so that by it you may grow up in your salvation, now that you have tasted and seen that the Lord is good. So we keep growing. As children of our moms, as children of God and Jesus Christ, a special day to know the taste of God that keeps us going, keeps us encouraged, even when we've been sad, even when it seems impossible, that the promises of God always stand and never fail. The Lord is good. Amen.
Let us respond now to God's word. Let us confess our sins to our Heavenly Father. Dear Heavenly Father, we confess our weaknesses and our sinfulness to you. Against difficult circumstances, we often try to find our own way through each day, rather than placing our trust in you. We sometimes even despair when you've spoken your promises to never leave us or forsake us. And so we confess together, forgive us for not always seeing that our hope is in you. For Jesus' sake, forgive us for our sins against you and against others. By your Holy Spirit, renew us for hope-filled living by your strength, living that trusts and follows your way always. Amen. Now he speaks to us his words of forgiveness. Our help and our hope is in the name of the Lord, in the life and death and resurrection of Jesus Christ. It is given for you and for me who trust in him. The forgiveness of all of our sins. Your sins are forgiven in Jesus. Taste and see that the Lord is good. Blessed are all who take refuge in him. And so now we take a moment to confess our faith through the words of the Nicene Creed. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in all things visible and invisible, and in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of his Father before all worlds, God of God, light of light, very God of very God, begotten, not made, being of one substance with the Father, by whom all things were made, who for us men and for our salvation came down from heaven and was incarnate by the Holy Spirit of the Virgin Mary, and was made man, and was crucified also for us under Pontius Pilate. He suffered and was buried, and the third day he rose again, according to Scriptures, and ascended into heaven, and sits at the right hand of the Father. And he will come again with glory to judge both the living and the dead, whose kingdom will have no end. And I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord and giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son together is worshiped and glorified, who spoke by the prophets. And I believe in one holy Christian and apostolic church. I acknowledge one baptism for the remission of sins, and I look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. And now as we come to that time of giving, as our Lord sends us into the world with the good news that Jesus is the hope for all people, we are reminded that as we give our offerings, we support this sending. And there are many ways you can give here at Memorial. You can give online through our website or through text, and that information will be listed in the comments of this service, and you can, of course, drop it by the office. We would love to see you. And now we pray. Lord God, we give thanks to you for all the gifts you give to us. For daily food, for health, for each breath we take, for our freedom to choose, and for the gifts of your word, your power, and your love. Lord, we also thank you for the gift of motherhood. And today, especially, we thank you for our mothers, for their care and nurture, for their love and support, wisdom and sacrificial giving, for the tears and the smiles, for the encouragement and the correction. Lord, we thank you that in such love we see a reflection of your own love for us. Lord, we pray that you give them the strength to live and to be loved in return, not perfectly, but humanly. Most of all, Lord, give our mothers the wisdom to turn to you for help when they need it most. We also lift up, Lord, the high schoolers, the high schools and the high school graduates and all others completing educational programs, blessings as they move forward into their next adventure in their lives. We pray for and including the Sioux Falls Lutheran School, the eighth graders that are graduating eighth grade and now moving into high school, and the Lutheran High School of Sioux Falls graduates who are moving on into college. We also pray for your blessing and care for those directly and indirectly affected by the current virus that we have in our community and around the world. Lord, we pray for the church gathered today, both here and around the world, that it may encourage all of its members to discover, to develop, and to use their gifts, those of nature and those of grace. Lord, we pray for those who are poor in body or poor in spirit, for those who are pressed and heavy laden, for those that are sick or in despair. We especially lift up those that are on our prayer list for this week, for Holly, for Brandon, for Melissa, for Amber, Mickey, Chris, John, John L., Erica, Mike, Mark, Doug V., Josh M., Chris, Marvin, Sarah, Janet, Marilyn, Ann, Georgia, Matt, and Greg L. And Lord, we pray for their healing and comfort in this time. And also we pray for those who mourn, Lord, for the family and friends of Mary Jane, the mother of Cheryl, who passed away on May 2nd. And we pray for the family and friends of Harold, father of Matt, who passed away on April 30th. Lord, bring comfort and peace in this time of transition. We continue to pray for our homebound members. We pray for Cheryl and Jean and Phil and Monty. We pray for our country and those in leadership positions, those that protect our freedoms, and those who protect our safety and our health. We pray for all of our extended friends and family throughout this community and beyond. Lord, minister by your Spirit and by us to all those for whom we have prayed, and help us walk faithfully in the path of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. And now we pray the prayer that he has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. And now we continue to praise our Lord.
Thank you.
One day when heaven was filled with his praises, one day when sin was as black as could be, Jesus came forth to be born of a virgin, dwelt among men, my example is he. The Word became flesh and the light shined among us, glory revealed. Living he loved me, dying he saved me, buried he carried my sins far away, rising he justified freely forever. One day he's coming, oh glorious day, oh glorious day. One day they led him up Calvary's mountain. One day they nailed him to die on a tree. Suffering anguish, despised and rejected, bearing our sins, my Redeemer is he. The hand that healed nations stretched out on a tree and took the nails for me. Living he loved me, dying he saved me, buried he carried my sins far away, rising he justified freely forever. One day he's coming, oh glorious day, oh glorious day. Grave could conceal him no longer. One day the stone rolled away from the door, and then he arose over death he had conquered. Now is ascended my Lord evermore. Death could not hold him, the grave could not keep him rising again. Living he loved me, dying he saved me, buried he carried my sins far away, rising he justified freely forever. One day he's coming, oh glorious day, oh glorious day. Sound for his coming. One day the skies with his glories will shine. Wonderful day, my beloved one bringing. My Savior Jesus is mine. Living he loved me, dying he saved me, bearing he carried my sins far away, rising he justified and freely forever. One day he's coming, oh glorious day, oh glorious day.
To send you with a blessing into your week. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord look upon you, his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. May the Lord look upon you with his favor and give you his peace. Amen. I pray you have a blessed week, and we look forward to next week. coming together again.